Welcome to this Digital Anarchy tutorial going over how to register Flickr Free and solve common issues in Premiere and Final Cut. When you're installing Flickr Free, make sure to close your host application, which is going to be Premiere, Final Cut, or whatever program you're using Flickr Free in, and reopen it once the installation is complete, and you should be able to find it in your effects. The demo version of Flickr Free has these watermark lines so that you can try Flickr Free to see if it fixes your footage before deciding to buy it, and then buying a license gives you a serial number that removes the lines. To register Flickr Free in Premiere and After Effects, apply it to a clip and then click the Setup button in the top right of the Effect Controls. To register it in Final Cut, apply it to a clip and click the question mark Registration button. If you don't see this button, close Final Cut, run the uninstaller that comes with the Flickr Free download, reinstall Flickr Free, and then restart the computer. If Final Cut crashes when you click the register button, you can probably fix this by updating Final Cut to version 10.5.2. 10.5.2 fixes a bug that can cause this crash, so update to 10.5.2 if you're working in Final Cut 10.5.1 or earlier. After that, click Demo to keep using the demo with the watermark, or click Authorize to enter your name, organization, which you can leave blank, and the serial number. You can enter anything for the name, but you have to enter something. It doesn't have to match the name on your order. You should copy and paste the serial number from your order to make sure it's correct. If you have extra spaces in there, or don't type in the dashes, or enter a letter O instead of a zero, you'll get a "This serial number has not been entered correctly" error. You'll also get this error if you enter a serial number for a different product, like if you enter a serial number for Beauty Box into Flickr Free. So make sure you're using the right serial number. If it's entered correctly, you should get a "Press OK to proceed" message and can click the OK button. If you get a "This serial number is for a different product" error, you're probably entering an After Effects and Premiere serial number into Final Cut, or an OpenFX serial number into After Effects or Premiere. If you bought the wrong version by mistake, send us an email at cs@digitalanarchy.com and we can replace it with a serial number for the right version. Different versions of our plugins use different licenses, so if you enter a Flickr Free 1.0 serial number into Flickr Free 2.0, you'll get a "This serial number is for an older version of the product" error. You can either purchase an upgrade to a Flickr Free 2.0 license on the upgrades page in our store, or download and install the Flickr Free 1 installer from our website. In Adobe Premiere and After Effects, serial numbers work on both Windows and Mac. After you enter your serial number and click OK, it will let you know it needs to contact our server to confirm your license. Click OK. If your computer isn't connected to the internet, or if you have a firewall or network security that's blocking Flickr Free from connecting to the server, you'll see an "Unable to contact Digital Anarchy" message, and then a longer message that shows your serial number and hardware ID. If you see this, send us a screenshot of the serial number and hardware ID screen to cs@digitalanarchy.com. And we'll use that info to create an offline activation that will activate the plugin offline that we can send you. If you've entered the serial number successfully and still see the watermark grid, it's due to a cached render from the demo. Click the register button to confirm that Flickr Free is registered, and then adjust one of the settings in Flickr Free. We recommend adjusting the threshold by 1, so from 100 to 99, for example, which will re-render the effect and remove the watermark. If that doesn't work, you can clear any old renders by selecting your project in Final Cut, then clicking File, Delete Generated Project Files, checking Delete Render Files, and then clicking OK. In Premiere, you can do this by going to Sequence and selecting Delete Render Files, or Delete Render Files into Out. We also recommend turning off background rendering from the Final Cut Pro Preferences menu under the Playback tab, and unchecking the background render option. Flickr Free analyzes multiple frames for each frame of your video, and you don't want it doing that every time you make a small change. If Final Cut Pro is unresponsive while using Flickr Free, turning off background rendering is the best thing to try first. In Flickr Free 2, you want to make sure the Use GPU box is checked. If it's checked but grayed out, click File, Project Settings, General, and under the General tab, make sure the renderer is set to Mercury Playback Engine GPU Acceleration and not to Software Only. If you change this, save and restart Premiere, and when it reopens, the checkbox should no longer be grayed out. And if you have any questions about Flickr Free or any of our products, email us at cs@digitalanarchy.com.